Now we come here to chapter 2. And chapter 2, we have the judgment of the earth and of all nations. And you have that presented to you actually throughout this entire chapter and all the way down to the 8th verse of the 3rd chapter. Now, will you note, as we begin here, God is a God who not only judged his own people, but God judges nations. And this chapter will bring that out in a great deal of detail. But before he does that, God is gracious, long-suffering, not willing that any should perish. So he sends out a final call. You'd think that he'd reach the end of his patience. But now again, he says, gather yourselves together, yea, gather together, O nation not desired. Now, in the first 3 verses here, we have Zephaniah sending out God's last call to the nation to repent and to come to him. And he begins, gather yourselves together. And it's, I think, just simply there to come together as a group of worshipers to plead with God to deliver them and that they might also forsake their sins. And he says, gather yourselves together, yea, gather together, O nation not desired. Now, their sin, of course, had caused God to bring judgment upon them. But it wasn't that he did not desire them. Actually, their sin had reached a very low stage, and they were actually dead to shame, or they had no sense of decency at all. They were shameless in their conduct. And I think that we would say today they had no sensitivity to sin whatsoever. They sinned with impunity. They would sin openly and actually boast of that. And we today as a nation have come that far. Someone said to me not long ago, they said, Dr. McGee, you talk as if America is sinning more today and is in a worse condition than it ever was before. Well, I don't mean to infer that at all. I mean to say this, however, that I believe that when I was growing up as a boy, there was just as much sin as there is today. But the sin was carried on back of the curtain or in the backyard or where it couldn't be seen. It was not flaunted before the world. It was not boasted of as it is today. In other words, it was not shameless sin as it is at the present time, as we have said before. This very beautiful little girl on one of the talk programs on television, she boasted of the fact that she was living with a man and she was not married to him. And others on the program congratulated her for her courage and her broad-mindedness. Well, may I say to you, nobody congratulated her for her shameless sin, because today sin is right out in the open. I don't think there's more sin. It's just out in the open today where you can see it. They sinned in my day, that's for sure. But it was done undercover. It was done secretly. And there was a sense of sorrow for sin. But we seem to have lost that today. Now, that was the problem with this nation here. And why that not desired? It's not because he didn't love them. It was because of their sin. They were repugnant. They were repulsive. You and I do not know how repulsive our sin is to God today. You and I spend very little time weeping over our sins today. Now, he tells them to come together as a people, as a body. They're to gather together.